We're running a giveaway. Please subscribe to our channel, like and comment on this video. 2 weeks after we publish, we'll be giving $100 to our favorite comment. If you're like me and you live your whole life online, you're probably starting to feel a little uneasy at the damage someone could do by getting access to all your data. So you want to come up with a few strategies for protecting your data online. This video will show you how to stay safe online by talking you through the steps to avoid being hacked, keep your passwords stored safely, and keep your emails private and secure. We'll start with 6 ways hackers get your data. Firstly, they find passwords by running them through a dictionary of words. So if you use words or names because they're memorable, you're vulnerable. Secondly, they use keylogging, where the hacker deploys a software called a keylogger onto your system. This software records every stroke on your keyboard and stores the information in a log file, which the hacker can look into for sensitive information like your username and password for online accounts. Or they add cookies on your browser. Cookies enable quick access to frequent sites, and they're required to make a lot of sites work properly. Once the hacker steals cookies from your browser, however, they can authenticate themselves as you and log into your online accounts, such as Facebook, Twitter, or your online banking. Within a few clicks, they'll have all your details in front of them. Fourthly, they use fake wireless networks. Hackers can use your favorite coffee house or public areas like airports to create fake wireless access points. You might think you're connecting to the public Wi-Fi, however, you're actually giving a malicious party direct access to your device via Wi-Fi. Then there's phishing. The hacker masquerades as a legitimate entity connected to you, such as your bank or a popular shopping website you use. They then contact you via text message, email, or phone, pretending to be this entity in an effort to get you to give them your confidential information, or inadvertently click on links and download malicious software. Finally, there are social engineering attacks, which usually target businesses. These attacks exploit basic social norms to steal confidential information. For example, someone putting on a high-vis jacket and walking into a building holding a clipboard might be given access to whatever they ask for because they look trustworthy. Good password management. Use unique passwords for everything. These should be strong, use numbers, letters, upper and lowercase, and symbols. Never save passwords on a desktop or in a document. Never write your password down. Never email your password to anyone. Never save your password in Chrome or whatever browser you're using, as it's very insecure. Use two-factor authentication where you can. Now onto some email safety tips. Always be suspicious with emails. A lot of cyber attacks are launched through simple malicious email campaigns. Email is actually a major security risk. The best way to avoid being scammed by phony emails is to just make sure the sender is who you think it is. Check their email address to see if they match the website you think it's from. To be extra cautious, you can check the IP address of the sender. Don't plug in devices you're not sure about, for example, USB sticks. Never open attachments. A good rule to follow is to never open an attachment unless you're 100% sure of where it came from. One of the easiest ways for hackers to download malicious code onto a victim's computer is by sending an email with a virus-laden file attached. A frequent way companies get hacked is by one unsuspecting employee downloading malicious software that infiltrates the entire network. The most dangerous types of files are Word documents and PDFs. So it's always worth finding the source information from the email and looking for the IP address that follows the received from line. You can Google the IP address to learn the email source. Don't put things in email that you wouldn't be prepared to see on the front page of a newspaper. Many people don't know this, but email is not secure. Never click on a link in an email unless you've verified the sender. And when I say verify the sender, I mean you need to verify both their name and their email address, and you need to make sure that you trust them. Even then, it's better to copy and paste the URL into your browser rather than clicking on the link. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked the video, and please comment or subscribe if you do. The more subscribers we get, the more of this type of content we can produce. And please stay safe online.